गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू? फाइन, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. ओके, यस, हैव यू कंप्लीटेड यूनिट 1? यस, आई होप यू ऑल आर कंप्लीटेड. नाउ वी आर स्टडिंग यूनिट 2. ओके, एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ 2 डिजिट नंबर्स. डिड यू फिनिश द फिल-अप्स? नेक्स्ट, कंप्लीट द टेबल, एड द फॉलोइंग. यस, यू ऑल कंप्लीटेड, इज इट? शैल वी रिवाइज सम क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम देयर? यस, लिसन टू द फिल-अप्स. फर्स्ट वन, what is the answer for 5 plus 0? 5, we add any number with the 0, the answer is the same number, that we know. Okay, listen next. 17 plus dash equal to 18. What will come here? 17 plus 1. Okay, 1 equal to 18. Listen to the next one. 24 plus 57 equal to dash plus 24. What will come here? Here the answer is 57. Okay, listen to the next question. 5 plus 4 equal to dash equal to 4 plus 5. What will come here? If you add 5 plus 4, the answer will be 9. Similarly here, if you add 4 plus 5, the answer is 9. Are you clear in fill-ups? Yes. Next, complete the table. Do you have any doubt in complete the table? In complete the table, we should add the number from 0. Okay, from 0 to 10, we have to add it. Okay, next, Roman letter 3, add the following. Listen to the questions. The question is 72 plus 14. Okay, listen to this question. 72 plus 14, add 17. Listen to the solution. First, we want to write the place value. Because here we have 2 digits. 1's tens. So, here we want to write the place value as 1's tens. Okay. First, we should write the number 72 plus 14. Do you know to write the number like this? Yes. Do you know to add this number? Shall we add? What is the answer for 2 plus 4? 2 in mind. Take 4 fingers. 2 after. 3. 4, 5, 6. Okay? The first one's place we should write 6. Next, 7 plus 1. What is the answer? 7 in mind. Take 1 finger. 7 after 8. Okay? Now, what is the answer? The answer is 86. Do you understand this question? Yes. Listen. Here, we didn't get balance number. Okay? When we are adding the number from the first place or in ones place, we didn't get balance. Here whether we have balance? No balance. Okay. So, this is called without regrouping. Okay. So, this is without regrouping. Do you understand? Because here we don't have balance. So, if we don't have balance, we should say that is without regrouping. Okay. Shall we see another one question? Listen to the second question. Listen, add 47 plus 89. Okay, listen to this question. Add 47 plus 89. Do you know to write the solution? For solution, you should write 1's and 10's. First, you should write the number 47 plus 89. Okay, shall we add? Yes. What is the answer for 7 plus 9? 7 in mind, take 9 fingers. 7 after 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, when we are adding 7 and 9, we will get the answer 16. If you write 16 like this, is it correct? No, it is not correct. Okay. So, if you get the answer 16, write the 16 outside. Okay. Now, we have to cut the 6. Write 6 here. Now, here we have your balance. Okay. So, you should write the balance number up. And again, we should add. Okay. Now, add what is the answer for 1 plus 4? 1 in mind. Take 4 fingers. 1 after 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now we get the answer 5. Again, we we should add 5 and 8. Okay, shall we add 5 in mind? Take 8 fingers, 5 after, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, this 13 we should write together. Do you understand? So, what is the answer now? The answer is 136. So, answer is 136. See here, we have balance. Okay, so this is called as victory grouping. Addition, victory grouping. Do you know the difference between without and with? See, without means when we are adding. Here, if you do not have balance, we can say that is without. Okay. But for this question, when we are adding here, we get balance. So, this is called as big regrouping. Do you understand now? Add the following. Yes. Today, we are going to study the next one. Solve the following. Okay. Listen to the board, everyone. Solve the following. Listen to the question. All of you listen carefully. John has 12 crayons. First one. John has 12 crayons. And Shilpa has 15 crayons. Shilpa has 15 crayons. Okay. John has 12 crayons and Shilpa has 15 crayons. Next, how many crayons do they have in all? How many crayons do they have in all? Do you understand the question? What is given in the question? Read the question. John has 12 crayons and Shilpa has 15 crayons. Okay. How many crayons do they have in all? Have you understood the question? What is given? John has 12 crayons. So, John has how many crayons? He has 12 crayons and Shilpa has 15 crayons. Okay. Next, we have to find out how many crayons do they have in all. See, for word problem, we have to write steps. Okay. So, solve the following. This is word problems. We should write steps. Do you know to write the steps for this? For writing the step, you should read the question again and again. Okay. So, now you should read the first line. John has 12 crayons. Have you understood this line? John has 12 crayons. Means, how can you write the step? First step, you can write the steps as number of crayons with the John. Okay, first solution. Listen it. Number of crayons with the John. How many crayons are there with John? John has 15 crayons. Okay, so John has 12 crayons. Okay, so number of crayons with the John is 12. Okay, again what is given? Shilpa has 15 crayons. See, so how can you write the second step? Do you understand? Shilpa has 15 crayons. That means you can write as number of crayons with Shilpa. How many crayons are there with the Shilpa? She has 15 crayons. Okay. So, number of crayons with John is 12. Number of crayons with Shilpa is 15. At last we ask, how many crayons do they have in all? So, how can you write the third step? Total number of crayons. Okay. Listen to the third one. Third step. Total number of crayons. So total means what we have to do? Total means we have to add it. Okay. So total number of crayons equal to 12 plus 15. Do you know to add these two numbers? Very easy. Already we studied. Okay. See how can you add 12 plus 15 means you should write the number ones, tens. Okay. Next. 12 plus 15. So when you are adding, what answer you will get? 2 plus 5 means you can get 2 in my, take 5 fingers, 2 after 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so 12 plus 15 means that is 7, listen it. So 2 plus 5, 7. Okay, again, 1 plus 1, what is the answer? 1 in my, take 1 finger, 1 after 2. Okay. So here when you are adding 12 plus 15, you can get the answer 27. Do you understand? So what is the answer now? So answer equal to 27 crayons. Okay. Answer equal to 27 crayons. Have you understood the first question? Yes. Shall we see the second question? Listen here to the second question. Second question, Imran plucked 14 roses and 24 marigolds. And 24 marigold. Okay, next, how many flowers did he pluck in all? How many flowers? Did he pluck in all? Listen to the question. Imran plucked 14 roses and 24 marigolds. How many flowers did he pluck in all? Okay, read the question once more. Imran plucked 14 roses and 24 marigolds. How many flowers did he pluck in all? Okay, do you understand the question? What is given in the question? Imran plucked 14 roses. Okay. Again he plucked 24 marigolds. So total how many flowers did he pluck in? All. Okay. Do you understand the question? So this is also a word problem. So for this problem also, we want to write the steps. Okay. Do you know to write the steps? Yes. For writing the steps, we should read the question again once more. Okay, listen to the first line. What is given? Imran plucked 14 roses. Okay, so how can you write the first step? We know to write the first step. Number of rose flowers. Okay, listen. The first line is number of rose flowers. What is the number of flowers? Rose flowers, number of rose flowers is 14. Okay, 14. Again, in the second line there they are given 24 marigolds. So, how many marigold flowers? 24. Okay, so how can you write the second step? Number of marigold flowers. Number of marigold flowers equal to how many? 24. Okay. At last they are giving, the question is how many flowers did he pluck in all? Okay. So how many flowers did he pluck in all? So how can you write the third step? Total number of flowers Imran plucked. Okay. Listen here. total number of hours. Therefore, total number of flowers Imran plucked. Equal to, how can we do? We should add these two numbers, 14 plus 24. Okay, this also we have to add. So total number of flowers Imran plucked. Okay, 14 plus 24. Do you know to add this? Shall we add it now? See, 14 plus 24. Okay, listen. What is the answer for 4 plus 4? 4 in mind. Take 4 fingers. 4 after 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. When you are adding 4 plus 4, you can get the answer 8. Next, 1 plus 2. What is the answer for 1 plus 2? 1 in mind. Take 2 fingers. 1 after 2, 3. So when you are adding 1 and 2, you can get 3. So the answer is 38. So how many flowers Imran plucked? Totally, he plucked 38 flowers. Okay, so answer equal to 38 flowers. Okay, yes. Do you understand today's portion? Today we studied two word problems. You see, solve the following. So do you understand the first one and second one? Is there any doubt in this word problem? So, you should read the question, okay, and understand the question. Afterwards, you have to write the steps for getting the answer. Okay, yes. Today's homework, mention it. Today's homework. Page number 32. Exercise. To your fourth problem. Okay, this is today's homework. Page number 32, exercise 2F, fourth problem. Write the question in your max class worknote, and you have to do the solution also in your max class worknote. Okay, yes, thank you.